Someday, one day, any time now, you may have a heart attack. It can happen to you. Heart disease is climbing. 1951 in Britain, nearly 60,000 deaths from heart disease. In the next 20 years, the figure rises to over 140,000, more than double. Heart disease no longer attacks only the middle-aged and the elderly. Being under 40 doesn't make you safe. Even in your 30s, in your 20s, you are at risk. More so than ever before. The effect we know. A terrifying rise in the number of deaths. People of all ages more vulnerable. And not just men, but women also now more susceptible. But the cause? Well, it's something of a mystery. There seems to be no single factor we can blame. But there are plenty that do contribute to the damage. Eating things that are convenient rather than wholesome. And nibbling between meals. If we eat the wrong things, it's usually by way of compensation. Any situation that creates stress is harmful. We can develop high blood pressure if our emotions are stirred up. Excessive smoking will aggravate it. Eating and drinking the wrong things won't help. Nor will fatigue and overwork. And if we prefer fretting at the lift to using the stairs, we're only hurting ourselves. Physical exercise is necessary to health. And in this case, it's a darn sight quicker. But it's not only at work that our bad habits can do us harm. Home should be a place where we can relax, not increase the tensions. Home is a place where we should enjoy the comfort and security of family life and the care and affection that go with them. Taking work home might push you up the ladder, but it plays havoc with your personal life and with your regular diet. Sharing things, however ordinary, like preparing a meal together, will do you almost as much good as eating it. But eating too much, the wrong things at the wrong times, is no good at all. Every extra stone imposes a strain on the heart. Imagine carrying an extra 3 or 4 stone about with you wherever you go. Does heredity influence your chance of heart disease? Well, even if there is a history in your family, it doesn't follow you'll go the same way. Nor does having long-lived parents and grandparents give any guarantee against developing heart disease. If heart disease occurs in a family, it might be profitable to look at the eating and social patterns, as well as to search for inherited factors. Eating sweets is as addictive as smoking, and just as harmful. This habit persists for the whole of one's life and does more damage than anything the genes may transmit. Children follow where parents lead, so they can be taught to eat and drink sensibly. To keep as active as possible. A car isn't always the best way to travel, especially if you're just popping out for a packet of fags or sweets. Sometimes, easier said than done. But we have to resist the increasing pressures of our way of life. Because it is our way that's dangerous to health. Our type of industrialized society produces the most deaths from heart disease in the world. But to blame the system is not enough. What of the personality of the people who tolerate it? If we simply resign ourselves, we accept heart disease as inevitable. All the stresses and strains of modern living, the demands we make on ourselves as well as others, bring the factors together. And they could be the tripwire that sets off the mine of heart disease. Some of us can cope, but most, literally as well as figuratively, take it all to heart. The pressures affect the way the heart works. They lead to high blood pressure and overworking the heart, to depletion of energy, to excessive smoking, which accelerates the rate of heartbeat, to seeking compensation by eating too much and nearly always the wrong things at the wrong times. Living sensibly, eating the right foods, relaxing as much as possible. These are some of the answers to heart disease. If we ignore them, the factors will go on working against us until one fine day. Don't wait until it's too late. Take exercise, relax when possible, and watch your smoking. Above all, make a start with the right foods, the ones that do us good. Meat and eggs, milk and cheese, fruit and vegetables. The right foods will tip the scales in our favor. The choice is ours, yours and mine.